Deal talk about osteoarthritis. What is osteoarthritis? Osteoarthritis is a chronic disease characterized by destruction and inflammation of the cartilage. It is caused by breakdown and eventual loss of the cartilage of one or more joints. Cartilage is a protein substance that serves a cushion between bones of the joints, also known as degenerative arthritis. First definition of osteoarthritis. Rheumatologists were considering osteoarthritis as only degenerative mechanical disease. But recently, osteoarthritis is considered a mild inflammatory disease. There is minimal inflammation in osteoarthritis. Minimal inflammation in comparison to other rheumatological diseases like rheumatoid arthritis, ankylosing spondylitis, and other autoimmune systemic lupus. In autoimmune disease, has mainly inflammatory problem of the joint. But in osteoarthritis, the main problem here is destruction or degeneration of the cartilage. Here we can see the difference between normal articular cartilage and osteoarthritic cartilage. The normal protein, the normal articular cartilage is smooth. In osteoarthritic cartilage, there are defects. There are many projections. The bony projections occur in the periphery of the joint. Later on, this defect is deepened, reaching the underlying bone, new bone formation at the end of the bones, leading to marked osteoarthritis and the after degeneration of the cartilage. It's the most common disease, most common rheumatological problem we see in our clinics. Osteoarthritis is defined by the American College of Rheumatology, which is our reference in rheumatology. Osteoarthritis is a heterogeneous group of conditions that leads to joint signs and symptoms which are associated with defective integrity of the cartilage. The normal integrity of the cartilage is a smooth integrity. In osteoarthritis, this smooth integrity becomes defective. Small defects early, later on this defect is deep in reaching the underlying bone. In addition to the related changes of the underlying bone at the joint margin, the underlying bone at the joint margin forms new bone in attempt to compensate the destroyed cartilage, but the newly formed bone is called osteophyte, hindering movement and adding to the problem in osteoarthritis, adding to the pain in osteoarthritis. Osteoarthritis is very common disease, the most common medical complaint worldwide, the most common musculoskeletal complaint is osteoarthritis. Osteoarthritis of the knee, we're talking about osteoarthritis of the knee. Most of the population after age of 50 complain of pain in the knee or problem in the knee related to osteoarthritis. Most of people after age of 45, especially women, more than in men. Osteoarthritis often occur at the ends of the fingers, small joints of the hand, thumb, neck, lower neck, knees, and hips. These are the joints commonly affected by osteoarthritis. The repair mechanism of tissue absorption and synthesis get out of balance. As a result, osteophyte formation. The normal articular cartilage is under a process of regeneration and degeneration. By aging, after aging, the cartilage age also. By aging, the cartilage regeneration decrease and degeneration increase. So the net result is destruction of the cartilage. There are imbalance between cartilage formation and the cartilage destruction. This is the pathology of osteoarthritis. Bone spurs occurring at the periphery of the joint. Bone spurs like that in the periphery of the joint here. The cartilage destruction, the cartilage become destructed, new bone formation, underlying bone become exposed, leading to manifestations of osteoarthritis. Here is also osteoarthritis, degeneration of the cartilage, exposure of the underlying bone, new bone formation, bone spurs at the periphery of the joints, the cartilage eroded, exposed bone, the meniscus distracted and eroded also, All components of the joint affected and also arthritis. This electron microscopy appearance or arthroscopy appearance of osteoarthritis. This increased tissue swelling, change in color, cartilage fibrillation later on, cartilage erosion to the subchondral bone. The difference between smooth articular cartilage, early erosions occurring in the cartilage, later on these erosions become deep and reaching the underlying bone. This is the difference between normal articular cartilage, early osteoarthritis, and later on severe osteoarthritis. The appearance of a cartilage under electron microscopy, the normal network of articular cartilage protein network interlocking with each other, which is different from osteoarthritic cartilage, which is replaced by bone. Replaced by bone, there are many defects in the articular cartilage. There is a big difference between normal articular cartilage under electron microscopy and osteoarthritic cartilage. This is also what is occurring in the joint. New bone formation at the periphery of the joint. The newly formed bone called osteophytes. The osteophytes at the periphery of the joint, like here. Osteophytes here. The osteophytes distending the joint capsule. The joint capsule become distended by osteophytes, which is causing pain. The cystis occurring here, cystis, bone cystis. Narrowing of the joint space here, the joint space between femur and the tibia become narrowed. Eroded cartilage and complete exposure of the underlying bone. This is a pathology of osteoarthritis. The difference between normal joint and osteoarthritic joint, the pathology of osteoarthritic joints involving all structures of the joint. The joint capsule become inflamed, leading to pain. The cartilage destructed, the first step joint cartilage destruction, followed by the other pathology occurring in the joint. New bone formation at the periphery here. The synovial membrane become inflamed, leading to decrease of the synovial fluid and decrease hyaluronic acid, which is responsible for normal viscosity of synovial fluid. Destruction of the menisci, formation of new bone leading to pain and limitation of mobility. Muscle weakness, the muscles here become weak, the muscles around the joint become weak. Ligaments inflamed leading to pain. So all structures of the joint involved in the pathology of osteoarthritis leading to pain and limitation of mobility. Osteoarthritis commonly affected hips, knees, feet, spine, and hands. These are the joints to be affected by osteoarthritis. By far, knee osteoarthritis is the most common form of osteoarthritis. When we talk about osteoarthritis, we mean knee osteoarthritis. Knee osteoarthritis is a very common disease. Osteoarthritis and commonly affected joints, this joint list to be affected by osteoarthritis, like shoulder, wrist, elbow. Metacarbopharyngeal joints. Metacarbopharyngeal joints affected by rheumatoid arthritis, but not affected by osteoarthritis. Temporomandibular joint, sacroiliac joint. Sacroiliac joint is the joint to be affected in ankylosing mainly. Ankle joint also, it is a weight-bearing joint, but osteoarthritis doesn't affect ankle joint. The distribution, anatomical distribution of joints to be affected by osteoarthritis. Cervical spine, lumbar spine, hand joints, especially proximal and distal interphalangeal joints. Distal interphalangeal joints affected by osteoarthritis, like distal interphalangeal joints buried in rheumatoid arthritis, but it is affected in osteoarthritis. The big difference between pain in the hand and swelling in the hand related to osteoarthritis or rheumatoid arthritis, because many patients may be diagnosed as rheumatoid arthritis. Knees, foot, metatarsophalangeal joints, hip joint affected in the lower. Osteoarthritis of the hand causing bone swelling, causing osteophytes of the proximal and distal interphalangeal joints. These osteophytes leading to nodules in the distal interphalangeal joints and the nodules also in the proximal interphalangeal joints. The nodules in the distal is called Heberden's nodules. and the nodules in the proximal interphalangeal joints called Bouchard's nodules. This nodules, which is a bone osteophytes, is specific to osteoarthritis, doesn't occur in any other disease except osteoarthritis. Different from rheumatoid arthritis, deformities may occur in the hand, but deformities here doesn't have deformity here doesn't have any pattern like patellar or swan neck deformity in rheumatoid. This may be flexion deformity, lateral deviation, any other deformity not like that of rheumatoid arthritis. Risk factors for osteoarthritis. Osteoarthritis is a disease of unknown etiology. Many risk factors may contribute to osteoarthritis. Aging by far is the most and the strongest risk factor for osteoarthritis. Most population after age of 50, about 40 to 50% of population at age of 50 develop osteoarthritis. By aging, cartilage age, the balance between regeneration and degeneration of the cartilage become disturbed, leading to destruction of the cartilage and the appearance of manifestations of osteoarthritis. Female gender, as like other most of other rheumatological diseases, osteoarthritis is very common in females in comparison to males. Joint alignment, any patient with deformity of the knee, like genuvieras, genuvalgus, any deformity leads to abnormal weight bearing on the joint, leading to osteoarthritis. Hereditary gene defect or familial tendency. Many members of the same family may suffer from osteoarthritis due to genetic defect or hereditary defect. Joint injury. Any occupation requiring prolonged standing or squatting or downstairs, upstairs, any stress on the knee, more stress on the knee, create destruction of the cartilage, frequent trauma of the cartilage, and development of osteoarthritis. The second most important risk factor for pathogenesis of osteoarthritis is obesity. Obesity is the second most important risk factor. Increasing weight by 10 kilograms increase the load on the knee by 40 kilograms. Obesity is a very important and very dangerous problem causing osteoarthritis. These factors lead to destruction of the cartilage, and the net result is osteoarthritis. Some of risk factors cannot be changed, like being a female, or family history, or increasing age. The risk factor cannot be changed, but others can change it. If we change these risk factors, we can treat the patient, we can prevent osteoarthritis, we can decrease the risk of being related to osteoarthritis. Avoiding overuse of the joint decrease risk of osteoarthritis. Avoid squatting, avoid prolonged standing, avoid upstairs, downstairs. Major injury, overweight. If you decrease the weight, your osteoarthritis will decrease. Muscle weakness. Muscle weakness, if you improve your weak muscles in osteoarthritis, the range of motion will improve. How to diagnose osteoarthritis? The most important, very important, how to diagnose. First, taking history of the patient. Then, examine the patient, X-ray, other tests. By history, the pain in osteoarthritis is a mechanical pain. What is the difference between mechanical pain and inflammatory pain? The mechanical pain in osteoarthritis is pain related to movement, unlike pain of inflammatory conditions. Like rheumatoid arthritis, in rheumatoid arthritis, the pain is related to rest. Because osteoarthritis is mainly degeneration of the cartilage, destruction of the cartilage, so the problem not inflammation, the problem is degeneration or destruction. So the pain here is mechanical, not inflammatory. Pain increased by activity. The patient complaining of pain after activity, during upstairs, downstairs, squatting like that, prolonged standing in the kitchen for female, the patient complains of pain related to activity. Swelling, warmth, and creaking of the affected joint. Pain and stiffness of the joint after periods of inactivity. Here the stiffness is few seconds to few minutes. In rheumatoid arthritis, the stiffness more than 30 minutes. Here the stiffness is few seconds to few minutes. The borderline between morning stiffness, inflammatory pain, and mechanical pain is 30 minutes. In mechanical pain, it is less than 30 minutes. By in inflammatory pain, stiffness more than 30 minutes. In severe osteoarthritis, complete loss of the cartilage calcium causes friction between bones, causing pain at rest and pain with limited motion. Later on in osteoarthritis, after osteoarthritis become more severe, cracking of the joint, friction of the joint, pain at rest and pain activity. First pain at rest only, later on pain with rest and pain with activity. After the development of severe osteoarthritis, progression of cartilage degeneration, progression of cartilage destruction leads to deformity. The deformity in osteoarthritis is bulk. The narrowing in osteoarthritis of the joint occurs at the medial compartment. Narrowing of the medial compartment causing genuvarus or bulk, outward curvature of the knee. This is the osteoarthritis result because of the narrowing of the medial compartment of the knee. People with osteoarthritis of the weight-bearing joints like knees can develop a limp. The limping can worsen as more cartilage degeneration. After cartilage degeneration, there is limping due to pain, antalgic gait due to severe pain. This is also due to muscle weakness. Patients with osteoarthritis have a muscle weakness in the quadriceps due to pain, due to abnormal range of motion of the knee joint. Osteoarthritis of the spine in a patient after age of 40 or 50, complaining of cervical or lumbar pain. The pain may radiate to hands in the upper limb, to the feet in the lower limb. This pain isn't related to a disc, it is related to cervical or lumbar spondylosis, osteoarthritis of the spine. Osteophytes occurs in the spine, compressing the nerve, causing radicular symptoms of pain. Very important again, osteoarthritis of small joints of the hand, swelling of the small joints of the hand, the bony swelling due to osteophytes occurring in the distal interphalangeal joints, bony swelling here in the distal and the proximal interphalangeal joints. The rheumatoid arthritis doesn't affect the distal interphalangeal joints here. Hyperadenous nodules occurring in the distal, Bouchard's nodules occurring in the proximal interphalangeal joints. These nodules are specific for osteoarthritis, different from that of rheumatoid arthritis. The swelling of rheumatoid arthritis is soft tissue swelling, not bone swelling. This clinical by clinical examination, the distal interphalangeal joint involvement in osteoarthritis, not rheumatoid arthritis. We have two major types of osteoarthritis, the primary or idiopathic type, which is the most common type. Secondary osteoarthritis may be related to infection, trauma, rheumatoid arthritis, other problem in the knee causing osteoarthritis. This is the overall all changes occurring in the joint with osteoarthritis. Lateral osteophytes, this is the lateral osteophytes. Loss of the articular cartilage here, defects on the articular cartilage. Subchondral bone sclerosing occur at the subchondral bone here. Loss of the joint space, the joint space become narrowed. This is the overall change in the osteoarthritis. Laboratory findings in osteoarthritis. Patients with osteoarthritis have no inflammation. Show the inflammatory mediators like erythrocyte sedimentation rate, C-reactive proteins, all labs are normal. We do labs to exclude other cause for osteoarthritis or to exclude rheumatoid arthritis or gouty arthritis like that causing the problem in the joint. But osteoarthritis is an insidious chronic disease, so it isn't acute problem. So by taking history of the patient, we can reach diagnosis in osteoarthritis. So the labs, erythrocyte sedimentation rate, negative, rheumatoid factor negative, seroactive protein negative. All labs are normal. Synovial fluid is non-inflammatory. What is meant by non-inflammatory? Severe synovial fluid is clear. The TLC in the synovial fluid is then 2000s. Normal viscosity. The synovial fluid is normally viscid. When we drop the synovial fluid from the syringe, it becomes like threads. Threads because presence of hyaluronic acid normally present in the synovial fluid. In severe inflammation like rheumatoid, like septic arthritis, like other inflammatory conditions, the inflammatory cytokines or inflammatory mediators destruct this hyaluronic acid. So the synovial fluid become watery in consistency when you drop the synovial fluid from the syringe, look like water, not viscid, not threads like that of osteoarthritis. We must differentiate osteoarthritis from rheumatoid arthritis, gouty arthritis, CBBD, septic joint, polymyalgia rheumatica. Radiographic changes in the knee of osteoarthritis. There is asymmetric joint space narrowing from loss of the articular cartilage. The medial part of the knee is the most commonly affected by osteoarthritis because weight bearing occurs in the medial compartment of the knee. Here the medial compartment affected, this is the normal joint, this is the osteoarthritic joint. So the medial compartment here, the space between the joints, between the femur and the tibia become narrowed. It is normal here. Here it is some narrowing, here is severe narrowing of the joint bony osteophytes and osteoarthritis. The difference between normal articular cartilage and osteoarthritic is great, different grades. You have four grades of osteoarthritis. First grade, mild narrowing of the joint space, minimal or mild narrowing of the joint space here. Here, decreased joint space, more decrease in the joint space, medial compartment. As we said, our weight comes on the medial compartment, so early narrowing of the medial compartment occurs. Later on, in moderate osteoarthritis, marked narrowing of the joint space, osteophyte formation here, this is bony osteophytes. Later on, bicompartmental narrowing, later on osteoarthritis, not only the medial compartment, but bicompartmental narrowing of the medial and lateral compartment, formation of severe osteophytes here in the periphery of the joint, causing severe pain and osteoarthritis. The difference between different grading of osteoarthritis. Also radiographic appearance, marked narrowing of the joint space, sclerosing of the margin, increased bone density around the joint because new bone formation like rheumatoid arthritis. Patients with rheumatoid arthritis have periarticular osteopenia. In osteoarthritis, due to new bone formation and the pathology of osteoarthritis, there is new bone formation. Newly formed bone leads to osteoarthritis, leads to sclerosing of the joint margin and increased bone density around the joint space. This is the bony osteophytes occurring at the periphery of the joint. The bony osteophytes occurring in the periphery of the joint in patients with osteoarthritis. Arthroscopy is rarely needed to diagnose osteoarthritis. Osteoarthritis is diagnosed clinically and by X-ray. Rarely we do arthroscopy to diagnose osteoarthritis now. Osteoarthritis management. Osteoarthritis management is very important. Osteoarthritis is a chronic disease. Many patients may have osteoarthritis. They don't complain of any pain. Pain only after involvement of many structures in the joint. We may do X-ray for the patient and he has X-ray changes of osteoarthritis and he doesn't complain of any pain because the cartilage has no nerve endings. So involvement of other structures in the joint other than the cartilage leads to pain. So we treat symptomatic osteoarthritis or patients complaining of knee problem or osteoarthritic pain. In treatment of osteoarthritis, we aim to limit pain, decrease pain, because pain may limit the function of the patient, may hinder his daily activities. So limitation of pain is very important. Increase range of motion. As we said, this patient has very muscle weakness, has very bad muscle weakness, which hindering movement, which makes them doesn't lead normally walking or normal activities in their life. To increase muscle strength, these are the main options or main objectives in treatment of osteoarthritis. Non-pharmacological treatment is responsible for 80% of management of osteoarthritis. As we will see later on, drugs in osteoarthritis isn't very efficient. So non-pharmacological treatment is very important and is very good tool to manage osteoarthritis. Patient education to avoid progression and progressing load on the knee. Severe load in the knee, avoid prolonged standing, avoid downstairs, upstairs, avoid squatting, normal walking. This is modalities decrease pain, improve range of motion, decrease allow the patient to lead his normal life. So to educate the patient how to modify his lifestyle and also exercise is very important. Self-management programs like swimming. Weight loss is very important. Decreasing weight by 5 kilograms decrease the incidence or risk of osteoarthritis by 50%, which is very important. Decreasing weight by just 1 kilogram is very important. This point is very, very important. Decreasing weight by just 1 kilogram decrease the load on the knee by 4 kilograms. It's very important. Physiotherapy. Range of motion exercise, we must treat the patient how to perform static quadriceps exercise, how to perform exercise at home, muscle strengthening by physiotherapist or the patient, assistive device like canes, patellar tapping, appropriate footwear, lateral wedging insoles in patients with deformity of the knee, bracing the patient may wear knee support to support the knee and improve motion and the improve walking, joint protection and energy conservation. Non-pharmacological by far is very important as the most important factors for treatment of osteoarthritis. Drugs. There are many drugs to be used in osteoarthritis, but the most important drug for treatment of osteoarthritis according to recent guidelines. Recent guidelines 2020, last 2020, released by EULAR, European League Against Rheumatism, and the American College of Rheumatology, they advised that the most important drug for treatment of osteoarthritis is the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs by far are the most important risk factors. So non-steroidals decrease pain, improve function, decrease pain. There are COX-2 selective, COX-2 inhibitors, and non-selective inhibitors, which should give the patient TBI. Non-steroidals should be continued if pain present until the patient become pain-free, provided that the patient has no problem in the kidney or in the liver, or active peptic ulcers, or the heart. We should give the patient non-steroidal as he have been. We may change non-steroidal. May change non-steroidal for the patient. The patient doesn't respond for non-steroidal. We can give him another non-steroidal. COX-2 selective or have less side effects in the GIT or patients with history of GIT upset. Acetaminophen or paracetamol is analgesic given for patients who cannot tolerate non-steroidal, patients with peptic ulcer, patients with liver or kidney problem. We may give them paracetamol to the dose of 4 grams per day. Tramadol may be given for patients with severe pain. Topical gel like capsaicin, non-steroidal gel may be given for sedation. Many patients feel relief with local gel and they become habituated on local gel to decrease their pain. Intra-articular injection of corticosteroids. The recent guidelines for treatment of osteoarthritis also in 220 said that corticosteroid injection is very important in patients with osteoarthritis. They advised to use corticosteroid injection for osteoarthritis who aren't responding to non-steroidal or other modalities. So treatment of osteoarthritis with corticosteroid injection is advised by ULR and the ECR. Hyaluronic acid is used for injection is used for treatment of osteoarthritis for more than 20 years, but the recent guidelines released about 4 months ago said that hyaluronic acid is important for treatment of osteoarthritis. They compared the hyaluronic acid with saline. They said that hyaluronic acid may be similar to saline in treatment of osteoarthritis. So hyaluronic acid isn't advised to be a modality in treatment of osteoarthritis. Also, it is very expensive for many patients. Many herbal therapies, many glucosamine, avocado, soybean, sulfate, cytokines, inhibitors, diacerin, recent guidelines released later in 2020 said that all modalities of no benefit in treatment of osteoarthritis. All modalities not significant, not important in treatment of osteoarthritis. All these modalities doesn't change the pathology of the cartilage, doesn't change the pain or doesn't decrease pain. So they said these modalities in treatment of osteoarthritis not significant at all. Glucosamine, chondroitin sulfate available in the market in many forms, sold in supermarket, but in our countries may be sold in pharmacies. The recent guidelines said that these modalities are not important, not very important for treatment of osteoarthritis. Many patients take these medications and they feel improvement, but I said that recent guideline consider these modalities as placebo effect. Total knee replacement is the last treatment option for osteoarthritis. This option should be delayed until the patient become older, because the artificial knee has a lifespan not more than 15 years. So delaying total knee replacement till the patient become sitting on wheelchair is the now solution for osteoarthritis. If the patient become handicapped, cannot walk alone, cannot go to his bathroom, so osteoarthritis can be treated at that time by total knee replacement. Total knee replacement is like that. We remove the lower end of the femur, the upper end of the tibia by orthopedic surgeon. I am a rheumatologist. This is done by orthopedic surgeon. And the artificial knee given both for the patient. The patient can lead normal life after replacing the knee. This is the total knee replacement.